भारत में आप कहीं भी चले जाएं, हर जगह पर आपको वहां की यूनिक थाली मिलेगी। इनफैक्ट हर घर की अपनी यूनिक थाली होती है।
आप जहां जाते हैं वहां की थाली में उस जगह के रहने वालों का चेहरा नजर आता है, उनका खाना और तहजीब झलकती है।
पर वो क्या खास बात है जो उस थाली को उस जगह से जोड़ती है? थाली एक अलग और एक अमेजिंग दुनिया है। आइए इस दुनिया को एक्सप्लोर करते हैं ऑन उत्सव थालीज ऑफ इंडिया।
वणक्कम। Today we're in the land of Thalaiva, the great city of Chennai. जिसका नाम सुनते ही जुबान पर इडली, डोसा, वड़ा और फिल्टर कॉफी का स्वाद आ जाता है। दुनिया के सबसे बड़े बीचेस में से एक मरीना बीच, एंशिएंट टेंपल्स और लुंगी पहने हुए चेन्नाइट्स। No doubt it's called the gateway of South India. अब चलते हैं मायलापुर, जहां कुनाल टेस्ट करेंगे चेन्नई का नाश्ता। प्रदीप चक्रवर्ती, जो कि एक राइटर हैं और तमिलनाडु में हेरिटेज टूर्स भी ऑर्गेनाइज करते हैं, ये हमें बताएंगे टिपिकल चेन्नई ब्रेकफास्ट के बारे में।
आपका जो आउटलेट है, it is known for those snack or the breakfast items like इडली, डोसा, वड़ा, सांबर। और ये वो सारी चीजें हैं जो सिर्फ हिंदुस्तान में बट इंटरनेशनली एवरीवेयर।
वी आर वर्ल्ड फेमस नाउ फॉर दैट एंड यू कांट स्टार्ट एट अ बेटर प्लेस देन मायलापुर। एंड दिस इज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट प्लेसेस टू हैव दिस काइंड ऑफ फूड बिकॉज़ इट्स आल्सो वन ऑफ द ओल्डेस्ट रेस्टोरेंट्स दैट आर सर्विंग दिस काइंड ऑफ फूड। सो वी शुड ऑर्डर समथिंग फॉर यू टुडे।
आई एम वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टेड एंड कीन टू ट्राई the sambar of Chennai.
So you'd be interested to note, actually we call it sambar, not sambar. Sambar is probably a dish that was created in Tamil Nadu, in Tanjavur, which is further down south from Madras,
yeah,
by the Maratha kings.
Okay.
The Maratha kings ruled in Tamil Nadu for a very long period of time, of around 250-300 years.
Okay.
And what is beautiful about their food is they bought Marathi food and they mixed it with Telugu food, which is already here,
yeah,
and with Tamil food as well.
Yeah.
So sambar is one of those inventions,
okay,
where tamarind was added to dal.
Yes.
And we should certainly try sambar. But the sambar is an accompaniment, like chutney.
Yeah.
But the big thing is for dosa and idli and vada.
Perfect.
So let's order for that.
Perfect. Let's do that. You too. इडली, डोसा, वड़ा, सांबर है, विच इज वेरी पॉपुलर इन तमिलनाडु, क्या ये थाली पर भी सर्व होता है?
नो, आई थिंक दैट्स अ गुड क्वेश्चन दैट यू आस्क्ड, बिकॉज़ दीज दैट वी हैव ऑन आवर प्लेट आर टिफिन डिशेस। यू हैव देम फॉर ब्रेकफास्ट और यू माइट हैव देम एट डिनर बिकॉज़ समटाइम्स पीपल डोंट ईट डिनर।
मतलब इडली, डोसा, वड़ा, सांबर ये एक स्नैक आइटम्स है, ये कभी भी थाली पे सर्व नहीं होते
एक्सेप्ट फॉर वड़ेस। बिकॉज़ आउट ऑफ ऑल द थिंग्स दैट वी हैव ऑन द प्लेट टुडे, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट एंशिएंट इज द वड़े। In the Shraad ceremony, it is the vade that we give for our ancestors. And that's a vade that's not made with a hole in the middle, it's actually filled up in the middle. So the fact that it's available in the Shraad ceremony means it's been there for at least 1,500 odd years, a bare minimum. This is something that is served with payasam, which is a sweet kheer,
yeah,
for any auspicious occasion during lunchtime. Well, you know, one of the things about idli and dosa is we are a rice-eating community.
Yes.
And when we have extra rice, if you keep it just as it is, it gets spoiled.
Yeah.
But the way to do it is to turn it into batter and then eat it.
Yeah.
So you'd rather save the food and eat it in a slightly different way.
Absolutely.
Rather than throw the food out.
Filter kapi.
So this is called a tumbler.
Yeah.
This is called a dabra.
So matlab isse peena hai, isse peena hai?
No, in this. But there are two ways to do this.
Yeah.
Is this called a dabra or dabara or a dahara?
Okay.
Okay. That's like a boardroom level discussion.
Okay.
But what is important is you can't have filter coffee if you don't have this like this.
Why is that?
Okay. Because just the dumb thing is just the tradition to do it this way.
I love it.
In fact, here it's made out of stainless steel, but the traditional ones were made out of brass. The longer you take it, the more of an expert you are. Well done. That cools the coffee.
I can do this all day.
You know that? You can do this all day.
Well, I got it right. Oh, this was hot.
Traditionalists will typically say, don't add chicory to this.
There is no chicory added to this.
Doesn't look like it. And the decoction will be really strong. The milk will be very little.
This is wonderful. Thank you so much, Mr. Chakrabarty. I think jitna fresh or interesting khana tha, utni interesting aapki baatein. And the coffee just stole my heart away.
Tamil Nadu ki sabse prosperous communities mein se ek hai Chettiars, jo ek sadiyon purani spice merchants ki community hai, जिनका मेजर ट्रेड साउथईस्ट एशियन कंट्रीज के साथ था। जहां जहां ये कम्युनिटी पहुंची, वहीं के स्वाद इन्होंने अपने क्विजीन में भी अपना लिए। और ये सभी स्वाद हमें टेस्ट करने को मिलेंगे मैंगो ट्री में, विच इज अ रेस्टोरेंट रन बाय चित्रा रामू, जहां शी सर्व्स हर मदर्स ट्रू ब्लू चेटिनाड रेसिपीज।
So today I'm going to be serving you the Chettinad Thali, and in that we have the Chettinad pepper chicken, which is called the Koli Milag Masala.
Koli is for chicken, milag is pepper, and masala is masala.
Yes.
And this pepper fry preparation, whether it's done in chicken or mutton, is it a Chettiar dish or is it a non-Chettiar dish?
No, it is, the pepper is the Chettiar dish. And it used to be the country chicken.
So it used to be more tougher.
Tougher.
Cook. More meaty, more gamey.
And also the flavors. See now?
Very different. So, let's begin. So, is there a particular variety of pepper that goes inside this dish?
It is from Kerala. Mm-hmm. But now it is more from Karnataka.
Okay.
So, all Chettiars do have estates and things like that. Mm-hmm. And so, we get our peppers from the estates.
Beautiful.
Start this thing. I'm going to add some few teaspoons of oil. We're going to add shallots, garlic, ginger. You can put all the chilies.
Matlab, ye spicy hone wala hai.
Yes.
के अंदर जो हीट आ रही है वो पेपर पाउडर से भी आएगी
क्या? देयर विल बी पेपर,
ग्रीन चिली
एंड द रेड चिली.
इतनी चिली?
हां, द पेपर विल बी 2 टीस्पूनस, सो आई एम एडिंग अ टीस्पून ऑफ सौंफ. देन वी हैव द पॉपी सीड्स. सी, फेनल इज अ मेन इंग्रेडिएंट इन अ चटिनाड क्विजीन. इफ यू सी, व्हेन यू हैव अ नॉन वेज देयर विल बी फेनल इन इट.
सौंफ होगी ही होगी.
या, स्मेल
लाइक सॉल्ट.
या, ऑल दिस विल बी ground into a paste. I have the paste here for you. So now I need some onions. Can you chop them up for me?
Oh, just you want
one
me
onion
to chop them?
Yeah, fine. So I'm adding some oil.
Okay.
Say about 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil. I can't cut like you.
I can't cook like you.
Ah.
We're all good. We're all equal. So onions.
Onions goes in
first.
Yes.
जो Chettinad cuisine है, I think वो काफी influence है Southeast Asia से भी.
Correct. Yes.
So are there any typical Southeast Asian flavors that become part of Chettinad cuisine?
They brought in certain things like the dried meat, dried vegetables. We use a lot of dried vegetables in the season because Chettinad is a dry area. Now we can add the tomatoes,
some salt,
little bit of turmeric. So we have the masala, so this will be marinated, but we have to marinate it overnight.
Okay.
So for the flavors to seep into the chicken.
Okay.
So now I have a marinated thing. So now the tomatoes are cooked.
Yeah.
So now we will add this chicken.
Aur is chicken ke andar wo sare flavors hain, spices hain.
Yes, yes. Chettinad cuisine uses the shallots more than the big onion. Because the small onion has, it is not sweet as the thing. So it will not sweeten your dish as much as the big onion.
The big one.
Okay, I'm adding some curry leaves.
Yeah.
Soon as I add it, you could smell the curry leaves.
Yeah, beautiful.
So now this will take another 15 minutes to cook. So let's cover it. In the meantime, we'll get the thali ready.
Perfect. So ye hai ek typical Chettinad thali.
Yes.
And must say you've been over generous. Ye bahut sari cheeze hai iske andar. But distinctively I can see a lot of meat. At the same time a lot of vegetables also.
Yes. See, actually there's a misconception that when you say Chettinad, it is only non-vegetarian. But if you see, the Chettiars were vegetarians. And because of their travel to the southeastern countries, like say Burma, Malaysia and all that, so they must have like had this type of food there. So that's how the non-vegetarian food has come into the cuisine. Today there's going to be, already we have 2 desserts, but I thought we'll be a little more indulgent. And then have this black sticky rice.
Very jammy.
Yes.
And the outer shell of rice.
Yes.
That is very fibrous.
When it is, comes from Malaysia, the stickiness is more than when what is locally grown.
I must say, jo regular rice hota hai, usse bahut हटके फ्लेवर है इसका.
Yeah, it is.
I have a rasam here.
Yes, it is the Kohli rasam, non-veg rasam.
Kalpasi flavor.
Yes.
उसे हम पत्थर के फूल भी बोलते
हैं. So in most of the soups, whether it's a vegetarian soup or a non-veg soup, we use the kalpasi.
I must say it's a mouthful.
Yes.
Feel that you get with this rasam. Rasam अक्सर पतली होती है, थोड़ी thick है.
Yes.
And lot of spices.
Lots of spices. Now that what you are having now is the uppu curry.
Uppu curry, which is
mutton uppu curry.
Mutton. Wow. I must say, बिल्कुल dry है. उसमें coconut नहीं है.
No, no coconut. The number of spices that go into it is very less. Mm-hmm. It is mainly it is the red chili, the dried red chili that gives it the spiciness.
चाहे वो uppu curry हो या ये mutton chettinad हो या फिर ये chicken curry हो, तीनों के अंदर जो मीट का फ्लेवर है वो बहुत ज्यादा स्ट्रॉन्ग है. स्पाइसेस सेकंड लेवल पर है
एंड इट्स वेरी बैलेंस्ड एक्चुअली. इफ यू सी वी हैव अ कूटू, वी हैव अ पोरियल. द पोरियल इज नॉर्मली एनी ऑफ द वेजिटेबल्स. इट कैन बी एनीथिंग. इट कैन बी अ कॉलीफ्लावर, कैरेट, बीन्स, डिपेंडिंग ऑन व्हाट इज अवेलेबल इन द सीजन.
दैट्स अ कूट. व्हाट वेजिटेबल इज
दैट? दिस इज टुडे वी हैव मेड द पोडलंगा, व्हिच इज द स्नेक गोट.
आई लाइक द प्ले ऑफ फ्लेवर्स वेयर द स्नेक गोट एंड लेंटिल is very mellow.
Yes.
I think sirf jeere ka flavor bahut pronounced aa
raha hai. Yes, yes.
Wahi pe fish jo hai bade complex flavors hai.
Yes. So normally how you have a thali is you have one of the gravies and then you pair it with the vegetable. So this is spicier, that is toned down.
Great.
So it's like an accompaniment.
Correct. And what about this bhindi?
Ah, that is one of the specialities of Chettinad.
What is it called?
It is called mandi. Special about this is how we prepare it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, lady's finger,
mm-hmm.
and then we have a bean. We call it mocha. It's a dried bean.
Mm-hmm.
So it is soaked overnight and it is cooked. So you have the tanginess, the spiciness.
Oh, almost like vaal. This particular bean is.
Yeah.
And it's a little mushy because of the bhindi.
Bhindi. Oh. Yes.
What about this? This is something very unique. I've never eaten this before.
It's the vella paniyaram.
What is vella paniyaram?
It's a batter. It's ground.
Okay.
It's not fermented.
So it is a batter made up with raw rice.
Raw rice and little bit of urad dal.
Is it like made on a tawa?
No, it is deep fried.
But I don't see a golden brown color. Usually fried things are brown.
This thing, we don't cook it for long.
I like the texture. It's just like a small little pancake.
Pancake.
जैसे हम लोग ना मालपुआ बनाते हैं. बिल्कुल वैसा ही है उसकी जो feel या लचक जो जैसे हम कहते हैं. बिल्कुल वैसा ही है. This is not lassi.
No, that is also another traditional Chettinad dish.
So I see these small little dumplings floating in sweetened milk. Now, is this coconut milk or regular milk?
No, it is coconut milk and little bit of condensed milk. And there's a traditional way of making it. So you clean up the coconut shell well, and then it has, you call it the eye of the coconut.
Yeah.
Okay, so you make a hole.
Huh.
And through that, the batter goes.
Ah.
So we drop that into the oil.
Press it down.
And
lumps ki tarah girega.
Yes. Yes. And then our pepper chicken that we made today.
Of course.
So you have this like a starter. Today we have it dry, which is more like a starter.
Hmm.
So otherwise you can either if you want to have it, otherwise you have it like a gravy, which you can have it with your steamed rice.
Just in case main khata khata aapko thank karna bhul raha hu, let me thank you so much. Kyunki aaj maine ek Chettinad thali दोबारा से खाइए लेकिन एक नए नजरिए से.
स्पाइसेस से भरपूर चेटियर्स का कलिनरी ट्रेडिशन रिफ्लेक्शन है इस कम्युनिटी की इंटरेस्टिंग हिस्ट्री का. आफ्टर अ ड्रूलिंग एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ Chettinad थाली, लेट्स मीट फौजिया कुट्टी ऑफ द फेमस फौजियाज कुकिंग, जहां मिलते हैं यमी ऑर्गेनिक पिकल्स एंड चटनीस.
Yes.
Hi, is that Fauzia's cooking?
Yes, it is.
I've heard that you do some amazing spreads, jams, pickles, chutneys.
Yes.
And they're all natural.
Yes, all natural, 100% preservative free.
I'm ready to feast.
Can I convince you to try out the lime and date pickle? That's our speciality.
Bring it on.
We like to call it a chutney as well because some people use it even on a bread.
इसके अंदर ना जो लेमन का जो कड़वाहट है दैट इज रिटेन्ड, दैट इज समथिंग दैट आई एंजॉय ईटिंग.
दिस इज अ क्लासिक बनाना स्प्रेड कर्पूर वल्ली. देन देयर इज अ बनाना कॉल्ड मंजल व्हिच इज अ स्मॉल शॉर्ट येलो बनाना. And we also have what is called yelaka.
Ilaichi.
Ilaichi banana, yes.
Here we call it yelaka.
I think it's yummy. I think it's fun because जब हम थाली खाने बैठते हैं तो ये चटनी और अचार ना बहुत छोटी छोटी मात्रा में होते हैं, लेकिन वो कहीं ना कहीं वो अनसंग हीरोज कहलाते हैं फॉर सम गुड रीजन. मेरे लिए दे आर द हीरोज. कैन आई पिक अप सम?
यस श्योर.
आपकी बनाई चटनी और अचार आई थिंक अब बहुत मशहूर होने वाली है.
थैंक यू सो मच.
ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट.
नवरात्रों के समय चेन्नई सजा हुआ होता है भगवानों की छोटी छोटी खूबसूरत मूर्तियों से. राकेश रघुनाथन एक साउथ इंडियन फूड स्पेशलिस्ट, फूड रिसर्चर और टीवी शो होस्ट हैं, और ये हमें बताएंगे इन डॉल्स की हिस्ट्री के बारे में.
हाय कुणाल.
हाय. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी ओवर. और ये आपके लिए मैं लेकर आया हूँ.
ओह वाओ.
ये है आम का अचार स्पेशल जो मैंने डाला है.
यम.
आपके लिए. आई वुड लव टू नो कि इतनी सारी भगवान की मूर्तियां आपने एक साथ क्यों इकट्ठी करी?
दिस इज द टाइम ऑफ नवरात्रि. आई मीन यू हैव चोजन द परफेक्ट टाइम टू बी हियर. यू सी द डॉल राइट इन द सेंटर, दैट इज महिषासुर मर्दिनी एज दे कॉल इट.
डॉल. मूर्ति को डॉल बोल सकते हैं?
हाँ.
ओके, इंटरेस्टिंग.
सो दीज आर मेड विद क्ले और पेपर मैशे. द सिग्निफिकेंस इज सच दैट
द देवी स्लेज महिषासुर एंड रिस्टोर्स द बैलेंस ऑफ द वर्ल्ड,
एंड दैट इज व्हाई एंटायर 9-day सेलिब्रेशन goes on. What's interesting is there are lots of pulses like your lobia, moong, chana dal. Every day you have to make navadanyam, a sundal, like a tempering, let's say, is made every day for 9 days.
Aapka ek utsav itna colorful hai, to wo utsav jo ek thal mein lagta hai, wo kitna colorful hoga? So jo Tamilian Brahmin thali hai, uske andar aapka koi ek personal favorite dish hai?
The arachivitta kalyana sambar, as they call it.
Sambar.
Sambar.
I would love to learn that as well.
Sure, I will teach you that.
Let's go. Chale.
Pehla ye arachivitta sambar ke liye masala banana hai.
Masala banana.
Oil first.
Gingerly oil.
A little bit of hing. So this is the actual hing before which is
processed
and made into a powder. This is a gum. इट्स अ रेजिन. ये है ना, इसका ओरिजिन अफगानिस्तान में है. व्हाट अमेजेस मी पर्टिकुलरली अबाउट इंडियन फूड इज देयर आर सो मेनी आइटम्स दैट हैव कम इनटू आवर स्टेपल फूड बट दैट्स नॉट इंडिजिनस. इट्स नॉट इवन लोकल हियर. सो अ स्मॉल बॉल ऑफ दिस, यू ऐड अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ चना दाल एज इट इज गेटिंग ब्राउन. यू ऐड सम धनिया टू दिस. यू ऐड रेड चिलीज.
व्हाट्स नेक्स्ट?
सो टू दिस यू ऐड सम coconut. So this has to be made to a paste. I'm going to switch this off and send it in for grinding.
Okay.
And in the meantime, we will make the sambar ke liye all the vegetables. It has to cook in the imli water.
Got it.
So I am going to add some imli water to this, some salt, thoda sa haldi,
okay,
thoda sa lal mirch, a little bit of curry patta, because I always like at this stage, if you add the curry leaves, it adds to the flavor.
Now sabzi.
Now you add the sabzi.
To a lot of people, sambar is just toor ki dal, usme ek South Indian tadka and done.
And what I've noticed is during my travel to research South Indian food, every 50 to 100 kilometers, the sambar keeps changing its avatar.
Yeah.
Okay, now we have to add the toor dal. So dal dalne ke baad,
we boil it.
Nicely boiling right now. So can you get now the flavor of the imli is gone?
Yeah.
Kacha flavor is gone. Now you add the paste. So when you grind it, it shouldn't be like a, it shouldn't paste, be too fine. It should be coarsely.
Grainy.
See, vegetables are nicely done now.
Yes. So this is done.
This is done. All you need to do is give it a tadka now.
Oh, tadka is
And the tadka is in ghee.
Mustard seeds.
Mustards, thoda sa hing. करी पत्ता, सूखी लाल मिर्च. नाइस. नाउ व्हाट यू आल्सो नीड टू डू, टेक अ बिट ऑफ दिस. दैट्स व्हाट गिव्स इट दैट एक्स्ट्रा किक.
यस.
ऑन द साइड. सो अरचि விட்ட கல்யாண சாம்பார் இஸ் ரெடி. அரைச்சு விடுறது, லைக் ஐ செட், இஸ் கிரைண்டிங். கல்யாணம் இஸ் வெட்டிங் அண்ட் சாம்பார்.
அண்ட் ஐ நோ ஓன்லி ஃபீஸ்டிங்.
Absolutely, that's where we are heading to, right?
Let's go.
Awesome.
ये जो टिपिकल तमिलन ब्राह्मण थाली है या फिर खाना है, उसके अंदर आपने बताया ना प्याज का, ना लहसुन का, ना ही अदरक का इस्तेमाल होता है.
जिंजर इज फाइन,
अदरक ठीक
है, अदरक तो ठीक है,
लेकिन लहसुन
और प्याज, दे विल नॉट यूज.
जो तमिलन ब्राह्मण कल्चर है, इट्स कल्चरली वेरी ओल्ड एंड वेरी रिच.
राइट,
व्हेन आई से वेरी रिच, इट्स बिकॉज ऑफ द लिटरेचर. और जो संगम लिटरेचर है, विच इज बेसिकली इट्स द हिस्टोरिक लिटरेचर ऑफ तमिलनाडु, जिसके अंदर कलेक्शन ऑफ पोएम्स है, मोर देन 2000 पोएम्स. और उस पोएम्स के अंदर वन कैन फिगर आउट उस टाइम का लाइफस्टाइल, द फोकलोर, द फूड दैट वी हैड.
इनफैक्ट देन संगम लिटरेचर, द ऋग्वेद टॉक्स अबाउट द बनाना लीफ.
सो इज देयर अ सीक्वेंस दैट आई फॉलो?
यू कैन फर्स्ट, यस, गो अहेड, हैव द आकार एडिसन.
अब एक बार मीठा खा लिया, I can begin from anywhere?
Anywhere, whatever fancies you.
Oh, yeh Koshambir?
So this is very, very unique. People don't really do it nowadays. It is our ancestors' way of putting a salad together. You know, it's pretty much that. So one is a sweet version, the other one with carrots is a savory version. If you notice, there's a lot of coconut that has gone into in the form of grated coconut and things like that.
Yeah.
So what wedding caterers do is, there's a lot of tender coconut water that you get while shaving the coconut.
Yeah.
So they soak the moong dal in that tender coconut water. This one.
Awesome.
So this is not boiled. This is not steamed. Raw. Nothing.
The sambar is amazing. Wo jo heeng ka flavor aa raha hai.
And this sambar rice, when you have it, sambar saadam, you have it with the aloo.
Shayad ye kehna theek hoga ki ye possibly Hindustan ki one of the oldest thali hai.
Absolutely.
And the oldest tradition of sitting down,
yes,
and eating together.
True, true. That is rasam.
Rasam always on rice.
On the rice.
No wonder jo rasam hoti hai bahut zyada teekhi ya strong, bahut zyada intense flavor ki hoti hai, simply because usko rice ke sath jana hota
hai. Absolutely. So before we end the meal, this is a very customary paan, but not like a meetha paan or anything. It is just plain areca nut which has been spiced a little. This also has a reference to Sangam literature, where Kannagi gives Kovalan a paan before he leaves for to retrieve or for the anklet story, which is very, very famous.
Thank you so much for all the wealth of information jo aaj aapne mujhe di.
I'm so glad I was part of this.
Thank you.
Think of a meal in the southern part of the country, and you cannot imagine one without a banana leaf. There are shops that sell only these all year round. If you want to experience an authentic meal here, you must have it on a banana leaf.
Kitne banana leaves aap bech lete hain ek din mein?
Yeah, almost they will sell up to 10,000 to 20,000 leaves per day, sir.
Main yahan pe dekh raha hu ki jo banana leaf hai, alag alag shapes mein kaat rahe hain.
For commercial purpose like hotels, the plates will be in different shapes. To avoid wastages, putting off instead of one sheet, you can cut it as per the design of the plates, it can be cut.
Oh, likewise.
So to avoid wastage, we are doing like that. In Tamil Nadu, it's our tradition. Eating in banana leaf, it's our tradition.
Beautiful. All right, sir. Thank you so much.
All right, sir.